Hi, today we are going to talk about how to migrate your WordPress site to our WordPress hosting package. There are tons of free and paid plugins under the WordPress repo, and today we are going to talk about one of them, Duplicator. Duplicator gives the WordPress users an ability to go ahead and migrate, move, copy, or clone a site from one location to the other. It also serves as a simple backup utility. Standard WordPress migration and WordPress backup are easily handled by this plugin with zero downtime. So let's go ahead and watch the video to understand how to migrate your website from one server to the other. So before we start with the video, let's understand how Duplicator works. The WordPress Duplicator plugin creates an installation and an archive file of your existing WordPress files and database. You then have to move these files to the new server. The Duplicator installer file on the destination will quickly unpack and install everything. So, in order to go ahead with this process, first let's log into the WordPress dashboard, install and activate the WordPress Duplicator plugin. Once you're logged onto the admin panel, on the left hand side you see an option called as plugin. Click on add new and now search for the plugin. Click on install now and then activate. This activates the Duplicator plugin on your WordPress dashboard and you will see the Duplicator plugin on the left bottom corner. Now, you need to click on Duplicator, click on Packages, and then you will see an option on the right corner that says Create New. This creates a new package which contains all the essential files that needs to be moved to the new server. Here you need to enter the name of the package and then click on Next, and the Duplicator plugin will scan your WordPress site. In case if you see any error messages, you need to fix it and then click on ReScan to let the Duplicator plugin scan your site again. Please note that the size check notice will be triggered at 150 MB and can be ignored on most of the hosts. We highly recommend you to check and remove all the backup files or any unwanted files to reduce the disk space of your existing WordPress hosting account, so that before proceeding with the migration, you do not have any issues. Once the unwanted files are removed from your account, please click on Build, and the Duplicator plugin will start creating a package which contains the installer file and the archive file. Depending on the size of your WordPress site, it may take few seconds or minutes. The files that you see on the screen, that is the installer and the archive file, are the two important files that need to be moved to the new WordPress hosting package. You can download them to your local system by just clicking on them and it gets downloaded to your local system. So now we have successfully taken a backup of your WordPress website from your existing WordPress hosting provider. Now, in order to complete the migration, we need to complete the installation of WordPress on the new server. So let's go ahead and see how do you go ahead and install WordPress on the new WordPress hosting package that you have with us. Once you complete your purchase with ResellerClub, you will see a WordPress hosting US package in your control panel. You need to click on Manage Service and this will redirect you to the WordPress dashboard. On this dashboard, you need to click on Install WordPress and it'll ask you for the WordPress URL. The title. And the email address. And click on Add Site. This will complete the installation process of WordPress on your new hosting package. Once the installation is completed, you will see the options like DNS, WordPress admin, email, and when you click on more, you have the options like FTP. Now, on the new WordPress hosting package, you need to click on Manage FTP and create a new FTP account for yourself. And click on Add FTP account. Please save the FTP username, IP address, and the password details somewhere securely. Now we need to go ahead and access the FTP account on the newly created server and download the wp-config.php file to our local system. In order to access the server, you can use any of the FTP clients of your choice. Right now, I'm going to use the FTP client, that is Filezilla, to go ahead and log into the new server. In order to connect via Filezilla, you need to have the hostname, username, password, and port number. You will get these details from your control panel. The username. The server IP address is your hostname. You need to enter the password that you had added while creating the new account, and the port number is 21. Click on Quick Connect and your Filezilla client will be able to connect with your server. Once the connection is successful, you will be seeing a list of files that were present on your new WordPress hosting package. This is the file that needs to be copied to your local system. As you see, the transfer has been finished. That means the web.config file has been copied to my local system. Now open the wp-config file in your favorite editor and note down the following MySQL settings for your WordPress hosting account. You will be requiring the DB name, DB username, DB password, and DB host. All these details are mentioned on the screen as you see. Please note that this is very important in going forward because we require the database details provided in the file to complete the migration process. Once you have the details copied to your local system, you can now go ahead and delete all the existing WordPress files on your new WordPress hosting package using the same FTP credentials. Once the files from the new hosting package are deleted, you need to now go ahead and upload the installer.php and the archive file which we had downloaded on step 1 to your newly created FTP account on WordPress hosting. You can either give the path from where you can upload the files or just go ahead and drag and drop them into the Filezilla client so that they can be uploaded to your new web hosting server. Once the upload is complete, you need to now temporarily map your domain name to the new IP address of your hosting package. In order to do that, you can either modify the host file of your computer or else use a virtual host extension that is provided by the Google Chrome browser. This is what the extension that is virtual host on a Google Chrome browser would look like. Here you need to mention the domain name and the IP address to which you want the domain name to point to. You can find the IP address of your new hosting package by clicking on the DNS option. You just need to copy the IP address and add it to the virtual host extension that was installed on the Google Chrome browser. Once you have set the virtual host, you need to now resolve the domain name on the browser with the installer.php extension. And this will open up the installer file. You need to just go ahead and accept the terms and requirements and click on next. Here, you need to enter the details of the WP config that was copied in the previous step. Once the details are added, you can click on next and then click on yes. This will complete the installation process and the entire website will be copied to the new hosting package. Now you can access the site on the new WordPress hosting server by calling the domain name on the browser as long as the host file or the virtual host has the IP address mapped to the domain name. You can try resolving the website once on the browser to check if you are able to see your existing hosting package. And if your website is resolving seamlessly fine, you can now point your domain name to the WordPress hosting package by modifying the current DNS zone of that domain name. Hope this was helpful. In case of any queries, reach out to us using the details mentioned in the description box below. For more such videos, subscribe to our YouTube channel and follow us on Facebook or Twitter.